Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a fun color grid mosaic from a photo. You can quickly replace the photo without having to redo any of the effects. Open an image you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. We'll use our image after we create our grid. Create a new document by going to File and New. Name it whatever you'd like. Make its width and height 870 pixels and its resolution 150 pixels per inch. The color mode is RGB color and 8 bits per channel. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Name it Grid. Go to View and make sure Snap is checked. If it isn't, just click on it. If you're working on a version of Photoshop earlier than CC, I'll show you what to do next in a moment. If you're working on version CC or later, click New Guide Layout. Check columns and rows and make the number of columns and rows 10 each. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. If you're working on a version earlier than CC, go to Edit, Preferences, and Guides, Grids, and Slices. Make the grid line 10% and the subdivisions 1. Then press Enter or Return. Go to View, Show, and Grid. At this point, the next steps will be the same whatever Photoshop version you have. Let's zoom into the grid or guidelines. Press Z to open your zoom tool and drag it over an area that includes the top left of the grid or guides. Open your single row marquee tool and click the Add to Selection icon. This will add selections whenever we click on our document. Click directly on the top horizontal grid line or guideline to make a selection. Press and hold the space bar as you drag your document up to see the next grid line or guideline below. Release the space bar, go to the horizontal grid line or guideline, and click directly over it to add its selection. Continue these steps until you've made selections over every horizontal grid line or guideline. Then open your single column marquee tool. If the selection icon reverted back to New Selection, click back on the Add to Selection icon. Repeat the same steps over the vertical grid lines or guidelines to add their selections. To see your entire document, press Ctrl or Command 0. Fill the selection with black by pressing Shift plus the F5 key at the top of your keyboard to open the Fill window. Click Black and click OK. Then deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Next, we'll place our photo into this document. Open your photo file and press V to open your Move tool. Drag the photo onto the tab of your grid document to open it. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down onto the grid and release. To resize it, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. If your image is too large to see the Transform's entire bounding box, press Ctrl or Command 0. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. Fit your transform onto your canvas. To reposition your photo, just drag it. Continue until you're happy with its size and position. Then press Enter or Return and fit your image back onto your canvas. Since we have a separate layer of the grid lines, We can hide the guides by pressing Ctrl or Command H. Make the grid layer active and drag it to the top of the Layers panel. Open your Magic Wand tool and make sure the Add to Selection icon is active. Make sure Contiguous is checked. This will confine the selection to just the one square that we click on instead of all the squares. Click inside the top left square to make a selection of its shape. Click inside the square to its right to add its selection. Continue to make selections of all the outer squares that border your photo. We want to make a new layer below the active layer. To do this, Ctrl-click or Command-click on the new layer icon. Open your Fill window and choose White. Then, click OK and deselect it. If you want to reposition your photo inside the grid, make your photo active and open your Move tool. Now, just drag it. Let's add a few more white squares to make the overall shape more interesting. Make the grid active and open your Magic Wand tool. Click inside a few more squares to make selections of their shapes. Click back on Layer 2 to make it active. Open your Fill window and press Enter or Return to fill the selections with white. Then deselect it. Make the grid layer active and click inside more squares to make selections of their shapes. Make your photo active and click the adjustment layer icon. Click Hue Saturation. The selection automatically becomes a layer mask next to the Hue Saturation adjustment layer. Now, when we change the hue of your photo, the layer mask will reveal the changes through the white areas, while the black areas hide or mask out those changes. Check Colorize and drag the hue slider to a color you like. Then, change its blend mode to color. This will revert the image back to its original tonal values. Make your grid layer active again and click inside some squares that you haven't already colorized. Make your photo active and click the adjustment layer icon again. As before, click Hue Saturation. This layer mask reveals the shapes of the new selections. Check Colorize. Choose a different color for these squares and change its blend mode to color. Continue these steps to colorize more squares. If you want to remove color from some of the squares, make selections of those squares and make the adjustment layer black-white. Next, we'll change the grid from black to white and then widen the lines. First, to save space in the Layers panel, let's group all of our adjustment layers into a folder. To do this, Shift-click on the top adjustment layer to make all the adjustment layers active. Then, press Ctrl or Command-G. Make the grid layer active and click the Lock Transparent Pixels icon. When a layer like the grid layer contains both an image and areas of transparency, we can protect the transparent areas while we edit the image in the layer. Open your Fill window, choose White from the Flyout menu, and click OK or press Enter or Return. If we didn't click the Lock Transparent Pixels icon, the entire grid layer would have been filled with white, making our entire image white. Double-click the grid layer to open its Layer Style window. Click Stroke. If your color box isn't white, click it, and when the color picker opens, pick White. Make the size 1 pixel and the position outside. Then click OK. If you want to reposition your photo in the mosaic, just make your photo layer active, open your Move tool, and drag your photo. If you want to replace your photo with another one, open the other photo and drag it onto the tab of your mosaic document. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down onto the mosaic and release. Open your Transform tool to resize and reposition it. If you can't see your entire transform, press Ctrl or Command 0. Adjust its size and position, fit the transform on your canvas, and continue to finesse it until you're happy with its size and position. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.